L3Harris was selected as the hosted payload integrator for the Iridium Next constellation. Iridium's in the process of launching their next generation replacement satellites, and when they were doing their design, found that they had some extra size, weight, and power available for other missions. Harris was selected as the company to design, develop, and put on these satellites additional hosted payloads that do different functions. In support of Arion, we developed ADS-B or aircraft tracking capabilities that are on board all of the satellites. And being good engineers, there was more room, so we also were able to put on board a VHF maritime receiver and collect AIS messages, which are transmitted by all the commercial ships around the world, and that allows us to track ships globally. What's unique about this capability is that we will have, for the first time, global, persistent, real-time coverage of the Earth. That means from every spot on the globe, at all times, we'll be able to get a message from the ship to someone monitoring it somewhere in the world within a minute. We actually use the satellite as our hotel. We get our power, our communications path. We've got our room on board, and that's where our payload goes. So Iridium is the transfer path for our data, which gives us the ability for real-time communications and the perch on 66 satellites in orbit. The Harris Operations Center, the HSOC, the Harris capabilities are all managed there. So we have multiple payloads and multiple capabilities on board the Iridium Next constellation. That's really the hub of operations that controls the configuration of each of the satellites, what they're doing at any point during the day, and how we deliver that data to our customers and our partners at exactEarth. Harris has the exclusive market for the US government. exactEarth focuses on the rest of the world. So while we look at intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance missions, environmental monitoring, environmental relief, pollution, exactEarth's dominion, it also includes commercial, a broader array of services that they provide to their customer base on both the commercial and logistics sides, as well as governments. The industry to date has had great visibility to the ships at shore, but in open ocean, it's been harder to see where those vessels are because of the type of coverage that satellites have had. With our capability, we'll see every ship on the ocean, and in real time, we could then say, this ship is now entering waters that it shouldn't be in, or these two ships are meeting up, and that's pretty interesting for the open ocean. Before, with the last generation of AIS collectors, you were looking at that data, but you were looking at it forensically. You had big gaps in your data just by the nature of the collection and the holes in the constellations. Now you'll actually be able to see that data in real time and compare that data against other things. Are my Nike sneakers gonna make it to the port on time? Can I gain some fuel efficiency by rerouting because sea state conditions are different? In fact, we're looking at using the GOES data that we are well knowledgeable at Harris Corporation for. Can we fuse those two data types together to add more understanding to the ocean? One of the fused products we're creating is a fusion of our imagery capabilities. We're able to fuse the AIS imagery and give you more clarity. Here's a picture of a port, but now here are all the vessels that are in that port and what they were doing at the time. And that, as a completely unclassified capability from commercial products, allows our government and others to share that knowledge between them without having some of the walls we have from other systems.